Joining me now from Atlanta, Georgia, attorney and former police officer, Mike Pugliese. Mike, it's a clear message to criminals these past few weeks, past few months, past few years, for that matter. And that is, it's open season. It's not just open season on anybody they want to pull up and shoot, a drive-by shooting or what have you, but it's open season now on police. We can't survive this way.
They have put a giant bullseye on every officer that wears a badge and is out there to serve and protect the people. I applaud our president. He has come out and he said, we don't need to throw all these officers in one basket. They're afforded due process. They need a fair shake. And reading all these police reform bills, now it's basically that they have caused a division between the government leaders and the police officers, your line police officers. Now, I've read these reform bills that are being proposed in the different states and even at our federal level. And it's absolutely, it's more than ridiculous, to underscore your words. It's gotten now where they have basically condemned our police officers without due process, and they're basically making them some type of enemy combatant. We can't survive. Anarchy is the right word.
Criminal justice reform, unfortunately, to too many in leadership positions, has been let criminals out of jail. You heard those police officers in Chicago say, hey, how about keeping the crooks in jail? And that brings us to the Rashad Brooks case. From what I understand, this guy was let out of prison possibly early because of the COVID-19 thing, but he was put in jail because he abused children, I believe his own children.
That's correct. And also there's some other information on Rashad Brooks that has yet to come out and make its way, because this thing has taken such a political nature. They have made the officers involved in this thing be political pawns at the whims of a DA who is seeking re-election. And it's unfortunate, because now you're telling these officers that not only do you expect them to go out and protect you, but now, lack of a better term, their butts are on the line because they're going to be prosecuted. And we're even talking about lifting qualified immunity against these officers, where now their livelihoods are at stake, and also anything they own is at stake through the civil process. It's absolutely ridiculous. You're going to see more officers leaving, and when you hit 911, no one's going to respond.
The video evidence in the Brooks case is compelling. It's compelling for a lot of reasons, but it's compelling for the defense. For the defense of this police officer, and we have this DA, Paul Howard, who you quoted. I'll quote him here in this story. He says, this is him talking, this is Howard talking. Mr. Brooks never presented himself as a threat, never displayed any aggressive behavior. Honest to God, I don't know what movie this district attorney was watching, because the evidence is pretty clear to me that these police officers were attacked and then tried to defend themselves.
They were punched in the face, and you could watch the video. They're trying not to hurt this guy when they're being pelted in the face. They're trying to put their arms around him in a manner where they're not hurting him, they're not abusing him, and that's when the taser gets lost. And, you know, now if you look at these reform bills on choke holds and everything else, the Democrats are trying to pass a bill where if you put any force on an individual's throat, that's somehow subject to some type of a civil rights prosecution. It's an awful message to send. You're telling officers, go out there. I've read part of the thing. They don't even want you to carry munitions at the at a peaceful protest. You know, what are you going to give them? Rocks?
Right.
I mean, I have no idea.
And it sends a message again to the criminals. Hey, you can resist arrest. You can run away, and you can get away with it. So here's the question. Who would become a police officer under these circumstances? There's a report out of Washington, D.C., that some 71% of the police force there, 71%, is now considering leaving the department. This is going to be cascading if this immunity takes place, if they take away the immunity, if they continue to tie the hands of these police officers behind their backs. This is only going to continue.
That's right. And plus, there's no incentive salary-wise to even keep them. I believe Atlanta is trying to keep the officers from calling in sick by giving them a $500 bonus. But when you're talking about, you're subject to criminal persecution, again, at the political whims of a DA that's running for office, that's a hard way to go out and tell somebody, enforce the law, we got your back. When we really don't, we're going to put a knife in your back. That's awful.
Somebody
tell
that DA that it was just a few months ago that he considered a taser a deadly use of force, but suddenly in the Brooks case, apparently it's not. Mike, thank you.
Want to see more videos like this? Click on the link below and subscribe to One America News on YouTube, and call your cable provider and kindly demand that One America News is added to your lineup. Call and subscribe today.